Right. So, in other words, now I'm not saying I'm definitively the expert on all these details. Okay. But the bigger point is looking at how people believe they know science when they don't, trusting in the statements of people they perceive as authority, even though time and time and time again, those authorities have been proven to say things that hurt people, that were wrong, that were proven wrong, that they admitted later, and so forth. Like, for example, if you believe, well, I think the vaccines are safe, and why would these companies lie to us and all this stuff, even though they've been indemnified from any prosecution? But the very same company that makes vaccines also makes like Vioxx, which killed people, and there's, you can go and look at it online. It's been proven. You know what I mean? Like, and so it just shows like people have this trust in the system that I think from a certain perspective, they don't want to question because of the cognitive dissonance. I mean, I remember when I was in high school or college rather, and we were talking about this the other night, like going into all like the 9/11 stuff and all that. And I remember the cognitive dissonance that I experienced. But it was my first real experience of no, actually I would say it was my second experience of cognitive dissonance, but the first really intense one that I was aware of. My first one was when my high school, well, it was kind of like a middle school, high school sweetheart that I wasn't in a relationship with at the time. When I was in college, I went to a party at her house. And so it was somebody that I had a relationship with for a long time that I knew, right? And we were family friends for a long time. And I remember at a party, I don't remember what the conversation was, but I remember her saying, "Oh, you still think your parents know everything?" Because she was like 3 years older than me. She was like already like in university, like or outside, like whatever. But I remember her saying that to me, like, "You still think your parents know everything?" And I just remember it like this feeling of like, what? Like I had never questioned that before. You know what I mean? Like my parents just, it wasn't like I went around thinking my parents know everything, because I would argue with them all the time. I would question them on stuff. Like we would always, our conversations home from church would be me trying to prove to my parents that God didn't exist. Right? And them yelling at me, piss off. So not like I just implicitly trusted them, but at a certain level, I did.
Actually, I was going to say that, I think most people's first experience with cognitive dissonance is we're taught cognitive dissonance from our parents. It's essentially like, if you've ever been punished or spanked, right? It's that like, I'm doing this for your,
Because I love you.
yeah, because I love you, or because it's good for you. It's going to keep you out of trouble and everything. And it's like you, if you just substitute parent for government, it's like, oh yeah, they're going to do some things that we don't agree with, but it's okay in the long run because, they really have our best interests in mind. But the truth and the reality is, no, they're fucking up, and they don't always have our best interests in mind. They come from that perspective. They say that, and they seem to, want that. And at a certain level, you're like, well, they couldn't exactly want me to fail or do anything bad to me, but the fact of the matter is, they actually are doing something bad to you.
I think you've just hit on a really important point, which I hadn't really fully seen since you said it so clearly, which is that's what is going on right now. Like the people that I'm describing, just the general mindset of, oh, you need to wear the mask, you need to go be social isolation, you need to stay safe, stay home, all that stuff, stay home, stay safe, whatever they say. Those are people that have not yet questioned that the system we live in does not actually have our best interests at heart. It doesn't actually know everything, even. Like, it doesn't know all the answers. It doesn't actually know the real science behind anything. It doesn't really even know how reality actually works. It doesn't even actually know what an atom or a molecule actually is. It doesn't, there's like at a fundamental level. So it's just like your parents when you wake up and you're like, oh, they don't know everything. Holy shit. Like, holy shit. And you realize, like, oh, fuck. That's an experience of cognitive dissonance. And I guess for me, it's like I'm only now making that. It's like obviously we know this, but it's like now I'm really seeing that clearly as we're having this discussion because I had that real massive experience towards the system when I was in college. So I had that first little one about my parents. And then years later in college, that's when YouTube was invented. That's when you started seeing like 9/11 and like all this other stuff. And it was just like, wait a second. Plus at that time, my life wasn't quite really working out the way it had been in the past, because specifically I wasn't going along with the path that had been set out for me.
Yeah.
The path that if I had just went down it, you know, I was at the Air Force Academy, which is extremely competitive, elite school, you know, and I left and I made a decision. I didn't want to do that, you know, and a lot of things went into that, but it was like that, because of that decision, it was like, you don't get any support then. You don't go along with what, where you're supposed to be, then you don't. And it's not that like family members and stuff didn't help me. I'm not saying that. There was some levels of people supporting me, but I mean, generally speaking, from the perspective of like, you don't actually get to decide what you want to do with your life.
You know,
from the perspective of the system,
yeah,
you don't get to decide. We have a place for you. You do that. It's like a doctor. Your place is to sell these pills, back us up when we say something, tell people to wear their masks, tell them to get the flu shot, whatever it is. If you do anything else, you're out. You're cut off. You don't get any more. We take your license. Yeah. You can't talk. We're going to put you in jail. We'll do all these things.
Yeah.
And it's like the same thing occurred to me at a sort of smaller scale when I decided not to go down that path that I was going down and really question, like, because, you know, one of the things that kept coming up in my mind when I made the decision to go to the Air Force Academy in the first place, and I probably told this before, is this thought kept coming up of, I want to be elite.
Yeah.
But it was within the context of my self-interest. Like, I want to feel elite. I want to be perceived as elite.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like the same reason people want to go to Harvard, if we're being honest, the same thing.
Yeah.
But fast forward to where I'm at now, and I realize what being the elite actually implies.
Yeah.
And I don't mean that in a negative way for anybody watching. I mean, if you want to be elite, you have to now take responsibility for the system, because that's what the elite do. We just have to do it from the perspective of what's best for everybody. So it's not like I don't want to be elite. We actually already are elite, whether people realize it or not. Like, if you make more than $32,000 a year, you're in the top 1% of income globally. We've talked about that in other places. But if you question things at any level, you don't get any support. Or in other words, support starts being withdrawn. You don't, your friends don't agree with you anymore. You can't go to do the same things you can do anymore. Like, if you don't wear the mask in some places, you can't go get food. You know?
We're getting impulse with that, like, on every level. Like, I can remember, just from what you're saying, do you remember if you wanted to get a scholarship just to go to college, like, you also had to check off this box that said, if there was a draft, that you were, you know, accepting that you could be called for the draft.
Yeah.
But if you didn't check that box, you were not eligible for any scholarships.
Like, yeah.
It's like, we're constantly getting, we have to make those decisions to go along with the system, whether you want to or not. Cause I know I didn't want to be selected for draft, you know, but I was like, I want to get these scholarships, so let me just check this box, you know?
I want to show you this thing real quick.